an ancient land of true majestic beauty. South Africa's Kalahari Desert is still ruled by the elements. And here, in this vast and wildest of places, one man lives among a group of tiny and fascinating creatures. Meet Rob Brains, a 3D wildlife filmmaker who is documenting the life of a group of wild meerkats. Over many weeks and months, he has gained their trust and has gotten to know each meerkat individually. He has shared their lives and so become part of their gang. Meerkats are very easily habituated. And having seen Rob's face every day for so long, they now completely trust him. This bond between human and animal is incredible. So let's meet the meerkats of the Gosa Gang. This is Cleopatra, known as Cleo, the alpha female and the leader of the group. Gandalf is her partner and the wise protector of the gang. Delilah is Cleo's sister and might well be planning a coup to become the leader herself. Napoleon, the lazy one, doing as little as possible. Solo, who has lost the love of the game and is often found alone and vulnerable. And the four mischievous meerkat kids. Starsky and his naughty brother Hutch. And Priscilla and Matimba, the caring sisters. Welcome to Kalahari Meerkats 3D.
As I document the daily lives of the Gosa Gang in 3D, I am also broadcasting them live in 2D to people around the world on the internet. This means everyone can look over my shoulders as I follow and film the meerkats and can ask me any questions they want, which I then answer straight away. I have learned so much about these amazing creatures, and now it's time to share.
We had a question from Susie from Idaho, and she asked us today why meerkats have so many different calls.
Standing tall at only 1 foot high, the meerkat is a small member of the mongoose family that thrives in the Kalahari. These gregarious animals live in groups, called gangs, and often stand on their rear legs to gaze alertly over the southern African plains. At night, they live in burrows under the sand, which they have to continuously maintain. Their home is their castle, their safe haven, where they can hide from predators.
Cleo is one of the first to come out of the burrow this morning, and her partner Gandalf is not far behind. They are the alpha male and female of the group.
Meerkats live in a matriarchal society, and so Cleo is the true leader of the group. However, as she is now very pregnant and due to give birth in about a week, Gandalf has had to up his game and is doing most of the sentry duty. When you are only 1 foot tall, the Kalahari is a vast and dangerous place, and meerkats need to be on high alert at all times, but especially when out in the open. The sentry protects the group while they are out foraging. He or she stands on their hind legs and often on a high point to scout for any dangers above or below. The second a predator is spotted, the alarm will be raised and the gang will bolt for the nearest place of safety.
Gandalf likes to get really high, and to be honest, having studied him for a while now, I think he's a bit of a thrill seeker.
The Kalahari is an epic place, full of adventure and teeming with life. And the meerkats share this home with many other species. Each gang of meerkats has carved out their own territory, and the best spots are often a cause of conflict with neighboring gangs. The Yakos Dune group occupies a territory adjacent to the Gosa gangs, and they have been known to regularly cross paths. When a land grab is attempted, the sentry will sound a specific alarm call, letting the gang know rival meerkats are approaching and to prepare to defend their home. Such disputes are rare, as they can end in fatalities. However, a roving male from another group may often stop by to try their luck with the females, but this is also dangerous. The Gosa gang have learnt that their strength lies in numbers, and they never stray far from each other, even when away from the burrow foraging. Matimba is a great forager, and often gets enough food for herself and then more to feed to the youngsters. Now she has found a large black beetle, which is a true meerkat's favorite. Her determination means she always finds them, even where others can't. There is one meerkat that does not benefit from the group's strength, as she has been ousted. Her name is Solo, and you can see her here looking on from a distance as the group forages.
Earlier this year, I saw her have a vicious fight with Cleo, and since then, she has been living on her own. She often stands at a distance when the rest of the gang is out finding food. I think she longs to be back in the group and have the security that comes with that. Her days are spent foraging on her own, which is dangerous, as she has no one to stand on guard while she has her head down in the sand, looking for morsels of food. At this time of year, there are many Cape cobras around. I saw this one raiding a weaver's nest just yesterday.
Sociable weavers build huge nests, and communities of hundreds of birds live together inside them. Hence the name, sociable. There are many access points for the birds, and this is where a snake enters on the hunt for chicks. The Cape cobra is a deadly creature, which produces a neurotoxin designed to shut down the respiratory system. The bright yellow, or sometimes brown speckled variety, is found in the Kalahari and has been the demise of many a meerkat. Today, it was a baby chick.
Solo is far from happy. She really needs to get back in with the gang if she's going to survive. I arrived this morning, and it looks like Cleo gave birth last night. You can see that there is red sand stuck to her fur, and her belly is drastically reduced. The pups are still underground, and will remain there for 2 to 3 weeks. This burrow is one of 5 burrows that the Gosa Gang uses in this area, and is known as the sourgrass burrow.
Daily excavations are necessary to maintain and renovate burrow systems. Often young meerkats will get one behind another and work together to move sand out of the burrow system. Hutch is great at burrow maintenance. However, his brother Starsky always prefers to play around and tries to avoid these rather monotonous daily chores.
It seems that all 10 are heading off to forage as they normally would. But what about the pups? Surely Cleo would not leave them alone underground. What is going on? What if a snake gets into the hole? There is no one to protect these vulnerable newborn babies. Cleo should really stay behind, or at least have a babysitter.
Foraging is carrying on as normal, and nobody seems to be giving a second thought to the fact that there are helpless pups alone back at the burrow. This is truly strange behavior for the gang.
Starsky is up to his normal tricks. He is the youngest member of the gang and is a real character, full of life, extremely curious, and rather mischievous. He has recently discovered the power of his anal gland, which is used for scent marking, and has been marking anything he can lift his leg up to, including my camera rig and the other gang members. Solo is here today. As usual, she is watching from a distance, hoping that Cleo will not see her, but trying to still feel like one of the gang. Maybe now that Cleo has given birth, she will allow her back in as a babysitter. She seems to be trying to get a little closer each day.
Delilah is Cleo's sister and a very strong character. If Solo can gain her trust, she may be welcomed back in sooner than she thinks. Solo and Delilah have always had a good relationship, and today they seem to be bonding well. Maybe the future will not be so bad for Solo after all.
I have been noticing that Delilah's belly is looking swollen. She may have gotten herself pregnant, which is very dangerous. If a beta female gets pregnant within the group, then she often either gets ousted or her babies are killed by the alpha female. I hope Delilah is strong enough to cope with whatever comes her way.
The Gosa Gang had made their way to the dam burrow. The Gosa Dam is one of Tswalu's most beautiful dams, and in fact, where the Gosa meerkats got their name. The burrow they built here used to be their only home, and where they spent most of their time. Recently, they have built and started using other burrows, such as camel thorn, sourgrass, and bird's nest. But the Gosa Dam burrow certainly remains the one with the best view.
I am still reeling from the fact that they have left the pups at sourgrass and not gone back to them. Things are starting to look bad for these pups. They have not had any food since this morning, and who knows what predators have been down the hole. If Cleo does not return to them tomorrow morning, then we have to assume that they are dead.
The weather is windy this morning, and the meerkats have come out later than normal. Wind makes meerkats nervous, as it prevents them from hearing predators approaching. Gandalf is once more the sentry for this morning, but he doesn't seem to be on his best form. Priscilla is one of the youngsters, and she often grooms her sister Matimba. These two are very close. Meerkats brush and clean each other's fur with their claws and teeth. It's an important daily activity as it strengthens the bonds between the animals and is the only way of getting rid of pesky parasites.
The group seems disturbed as they head off to forage this morning. Delilah and three males have split off and are foraging on their own.
Delilah, while very courageous, is also a highly strung beta female who keeps her distance from the alpha pair. The three males that she is foraging with today are Napoleon, Brutus, and Dingaan. All are fairly submissive to Delilah, and maybe that is why she has split off with them. Napoleon, however, tends to be very lazy and struggles to work well in a team. He is often found hiding far from the group when daily chores are being carried out.
I am now sure that Delilah is pregnant. Her belly is getting bigger every day, and this split from the rest of the gang is certainly suspicious. Delilah may be distancing herself from Cleo, as she is afraid that Cleo will kill her pups.
However, sometimes a group splits naturally when there has been a difficult traumatic event. The loss of Cleo's pups has certainly been a very difficult time for the meerkat family, and this could have been the cause of the divide and the splintering of the group.
I have returned to the sourgrass burrow to see what I can find, and it is overwhelmingly quiet. It has an eerie feel to it. There is a snake track that moves away from the burrow hole, which adds to the mystery. There is no way that they would have survived this long without food, and it makes sense for a predator to cash in on this unfortunate situation. I am not sure if the pups were stillborn, whether they were killed by a predator, or if Cleo is a poor or inexperienced mother. I guess we will never know. It is a very sad and confusing time for both me and the Gosa Gang. But life carries on here in the Kalahari, and the death of one is another one's gain. The circle of life.
Last night, Delilah and her group slept at the camel thorn burrow. Camel thorn trees are endemic to the Kalahari, and this beautiful, slow-growing tree does well in poor soils and in harsh environmental conditions. Meerkats will often use the inside of one of these trees to forage, as it is the perfect place for one of their favorite foods, the scorpion. They even risk encounters with snakes to find this delicacy. This morning, a lone meerkat can be seen coming towards them. It is Solo. She is now trying her luck with Delilah. She knows that Delilah is also not on good terms with Cleo, and if they can unite, then together they can possibly depose Cleo as the gang's leader. Delilah seems unfazed, and for now the five of them forage together. The Gosa meerkats really love the yellowish-white beetle larvae that are found out here in the Kalahari. These larvae belong to a large and diverse family of beetles. You can always tell if a meerkat has sniffed one of these juicy treats out, as they will frantically dig deeper and deeper to find this tantalizing treasure. Delilah is a strong forager, and with her leadership skills, she holds the group together. She must, however, know that if they don't reunite with the rest of the gang, both groups could be in trouble.
Cleo and her group are still sleeping at the dam burrow, but they seem uneasy. It is a beautiful burrow, overlooking the dam, but it is also very open and exposed. I am guessing that Cleo chose this burrow because she feels vulnerable and needs to be able to see in all directions.
Often animals can be seen on the other side of the dam. They seem to be able to live in harmony with the meerkats, as neither feels threatened. In fact, the meerkats enjoy these herbivores being around, as it means more eyes to look for danger.
The gang spent the day foraging fairly far east before making their way back to the Gosa Dam burrow. As they approached from the northeast, the Gossas were suddenly on high alert, as something to the south grabbed their attention. I looked towards the dam and saw three meerkats sitting on top of the Gosa Dam burrow. Ah, there's the rest of the group, I thought. But when I looked again, there were five. I looked back at the Gosa gang, who were now firmly on the alert. And when I looked back in the direction of the dam, there were eight meerkats. I looked frantically back at the six Gosa members, and then back to the dam, and now there were 11. Was this a mirage? Where did all these meerkats come from? And then it hit me. The Yaku's Dune gang have launched an expedition deep into the Gosa territory. The six Gosa gang members moved forwards, bounding and chirping as they came closer to the Gosa dam burrow. Both groups of meerkats were now at full alert, tails raised, backs arched, ready for action. Suddenly, the Yaku's Dune invaders rushed down the embankment towards the Gosa gang, bounding bravely forward with tails aimed high. And what did our gang do? They turned tail and literally flew back to their bird's nest burrow. I caught up with the Gosa gang at Bird's Nest Burrow. Nervous and very taken aback, the group sat on top of the burrow and stared back in the direction of the Gosa dam. They had just lost a piece of prime meerkat real estate to a bunch of marauding invaders.
Yako's Dune group has 20 meerkats. They are much stronger than the Gossas and may use this time of confusion to take over their territory. A mood of sadness descends upon the gang. Losing the Gosa Dam burrow is a real blow. It is the best burrow in the area because predators could be seen approaching. The gang felt safe there, but now it is lost. This morning, Solo is again foraging with Delilah's group, and it looks like this may be her way back into the family. She is so happy to have the security of a group again. Having been on her own for so long, even just four other meerkats inviting her into a dysfunctional family is amazing. Delilah seems to have made the decision to try and move back with the splinter group into the rest of the family. Splitting the family is pointless, as both groups will be weaker. She understands that her pups may be in danger once they are born, but for now, there is little point in being separated. Particularly while this Yako's Dune invasion is underway, the Gosa gang needs to stand together. The renegades head to Bird's Nest Burrow, where Cleo and the rest of the gang slept last night.
There they are, relaxing after the previous night's excitement.
Meerkats constantly communicate with one another in three different ways: scent, sound, and body language. Over 20 different sounds have been recorded, each with a different meaning. Calls are used when warning the group of an aerial or terrestrial predator. In addition to alarm calls, meerkats also make panic calls, recruitment calls, moving calls, and bonding sounds. While Rob has been filming and spending time with the gang, he has been making meerkat-type noises. As a result, the meerkats have been much quicker to accept him as one of their own. He realized that by acting like a meerkat, it's much easier to get closer to them and be a normal part of their lives. On approaching the main group, Delilah, Dingon, Brutus, Napoleon, and Solo moved submissively towards Cleo. And fortunately, she is happy to let them back in. There was a quick reunion with mutual grooming and burrow maintenance, and everything looked like it was completely back to normal. 11 meerkats in the Gosa Gang all together for the first time in 3 months. Suddenly, the atmosphere of the group changed, and it became obvious why Cleo had so happily let the others back in. She had decided to fight the Yucko's dune invaders for the precious Gosa Dam burrow. To stand any chance of success, she needs the family at full strength. Gosa's 11 then approached the dam from the northwest, hoping to use the element of surprise to catch their enemies off guard. But as they got close, they found the whole Yucko's dune gang waiting for them, ready for battle. Due to give birth in about a week, Gandalf has had to up his game and is doing most of the sentry duty. When you are only 1 foot tall, The Kalahari is a vast and dangerous place, and meerkats need to be on high alert at all times, but especially when out in the open. The sentry protects the group while they are out foraging. He or she stands on their hind legs and often on a high point to scout for any dangers above or below. The second a predator is spotted, the alarm will be raised and the gang will bolt for the nearest place of safety.
Gandalf likes to get really high, and to be honest, having studied him for a while now, I think he's a bit of a thrill seeker.
The Kalahari is an epic place, full of adventure and teeming with life. And the meerkats share this home with many other species. Each gang of meerkats has carved out their own territory, and the best spots are often a cause of conflict with neighboring gangs. The Yakos Dune group occupies a territory adjacent to the Gosa gangs, and they have been known to regularly cross paths. When a land grab is attempted, the sentry will sound a specific alarm call, letting the gang know rival meerkats are approaching and to prepare to defend their home. Such disputes are rare, as they can end in fatalities. However, a roving male from another group may often stop by to try their luck with the females, but this is also dangerous. The Gosa gang have learnt that their strength lies in numbers, and they never stray far from each other, even when away from the burrow foraging. Matimba is a great forager, and often gets enough food for herself and then more to feed to the youngsters. Now she has found a large black beetle, which is a true meerkat's favorite. Her determination means she always finds them, even where others can't. There is one meerkat that does not benefit from the group's strength, as she has been ousted. Her name is Solo, and you can see her here looking on from a distance as the group forages.
Earlier this year, I saw her have a vicious fight with...
Meerkats are very easily habituated, and having seen Rob's face every day for so long, they now completely trust him. This bond between human and animal is incredible. So let's meet the meerkats of the Gosa gang. This is Cleopatra, known as Cleo, the alpha female and the leader of the group. Gandalf is her partner and the wise protector of the gang. Delilah is Cleo's sister and might well be planning a coup to become the leader herself. Napoleon, the lazy one, doing as little as possible. Solo, who has lost the love of the gang and is often found alone and vulnerable. And the four mischievous meerkat kids. Starsky and his naughty brother Hutch. And Priscilla and Matimba, the caring sisters. Welcome to Kalahari Meerkats 3D.
As I document the daily lives of the Gosa gang in 3D, I am also broadcasting them live in 2D. To people around the world on the internet. This means everyone can...
An ancient land of true majestic beauty. South Africa's Kalahari Desert is still ruled by the elements. Thank you. And here, in this vast and wildest of places, one man lives among a group of tiny and fascinating creatures. Meet Rob Brains, a 3D wildlife filmmaker who is documenting the life of a group of wild meerkats. Over many weeks and months, he has gained their trust and has gotten to know each meerkat individually. He has shared their lives and so become part of their gang.
Look over my shoulders as I follow and film the meerkats and can ask me any questions they want, which I then answer straight away. I have learned so much about these amazing creatures, and now it's time to share.
We had a question from Susie from Idaho, and she asked us today why meerkats have so many different calls.
Standing tall at only 1 foot high, the meerkat is a small member of the mongoose family that thrives in the Kalahari. These gregarious animals live in groups called gangs, and often stand on their rear legs to gaze alertly over the southern African plains. At night, they live in burrows under the sand, which they have to continuously maintain. Their home is their castle, their safe haven, where they can hide from predators.
Cleo is one of the first to come out of the burrow this morning, and her partner Gandalf is not far behind. They are the alpha male and female of the group.
Meerkats live in a matriarchal society, and so Cleo is the true leader of the group. However, as she is now very pregnant,